In this video, I want to talk you through getting a CSV file into Xero. First, let's have a look at what type of information Xero wants from us. Once we're on our dashboard, we have got our bank account, and we click on the three dots on the right side of it. Then we choose the option to import a statement. You can see here that we have an option to import a CSV file. If we want to do that, there is a Xero template that we can use, so let's see what it looks like. We can see here that there are only two fields that are required, date and amount. There are other fields that you can use, such as payee, description, reference, and check number, but those are not required. You might get a bank statement from your bank already in CSV format, but what if you get it in a PDF file instead? Does that mean you have to enter all this data manually? No. Here's a very quick and simple way to turn it into CSV, so you can upload it to Xero. Go to extract.ai and either log in or create a new account. Now we go to the tab where it says Create a Template. Instead of creating a new template, you can see that extract.ai already has this exact template for Xero, so we're just going to use this pre-made one. You can delete the fields you don't find relevant. Just remember to keep date and amount, as these two fields are mandatory. I will delete the check number, as my bank statement doesn't have any, and leave the rest as it is. Once you've adjusted the template to your needs, you can proceed to save it. Now we click on the tab, New Extraction. Make sure you select the right template for the extraction. In our case, that is a bank statement, Xero template. After we put in the subject, we can just drag and drop our file and extract.ai will do the rest. Results will be available under the extractions page. Wait for the extraction to finish and refresh the page. Once the extraction is done, we can go to tab Downloads and download our file in CSV format. Here is what it looks like. We are now ready to go back to Xero and upload the downloaded CSV file. Click Next. Now Xero is asking us to confirm statement lines imported from our file, so we check if everything is in order. Make sure you have ticked the box, "Don't import the first line," because there are headings. Once we are sure everything is in order, we click Next again. If the imported data is correct, we can proceed to complete the import. This is what the finished result looks like. Easy, right? Click the link in the bio to find out more.